Radio.
Hello, Bela.
Hello.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you also.
Okay, your work is mostly inspired by marine lighthouses. Okay, why did you choose them?
Actually, it's not really me choosing them. I think I have been chosen as I've been born at the seaside in Varna in Bulgaria. And I've been having the sea for the first 6 years of my life. Then my family moved me to the capital, away from the sea, and I've been always longing to get back again to the water. And when I managed to do it, it was some 20 and even more years later, I rediscovered the lighthouses, the coast, and it has become since then a passion that has covered a lot of countries, not only mine.
Good, good. Okay, where was the most beautiful one you had ever seen?
I hate this question. There is no one most beautiful. It's all of them so beautiful. Yeah. But, well, if I have to really put one aside, it would be Shabla Lighthouse in Bulgaria, because of the architecture and the history behind it, and because it's really inspiring. I've been inside several times. And this sensation of something very, very old, some people dated to 250 years, this feeling of something that will overcome the time and remain forever and guide everyone, even when ships don't need lighthouses anymore, it's really overwhelming. I believe that's my most favorite so far.
Okay. How many photographs do you present in the exhibition?
Here, I did not actually count, but it's some 50 photographs in the exhibition here in Veliko Trnovo, and they have been changing with all the venues of the exhibition. Actually, I only do repeat the Bulgarian lights, and all the others, when they appear once, if somebody likes them and buys them, they go to be the light at home, the lighthouse at home in somebody's home. And then I put another one, another brand new one. So this exhibition is really moving all the time. It's really changing and I like it this way. So here it's some 50, but it depends on the people. Maybe tonight we are going to see some more.
Okay, good. You have traveled a lot in more than 20 countries. Okay, good. Which place was the hardest to get to?
The hardest to get to with the bicycle, oh, depends a lot. There has been very hard parts in European part of Turkey, very challenging on the physical side. Then in some countries, sometimes there are difficulties related to the access to the lighthouse. I'm not proud, but I've been doing trespassing a lot, international trespassing, and I'll be doing this again, I know, in countries when they're not gonna shoot me. I believe the hardest is still to come, as I haven't been yet to really dangerous countries. But when I'm done with the not so dangerous ones, I'm gonna go for this.
Good. Okay, your first exhibition was in 2007. Okay, in your hometown, Varna. Okay, could you tell us more about it?
The first exhibition actually was not the same one. It was an exhibition telling the story of my first bicycle lighthouse journey. Actually, it's the same story that is here in the book.
Yeah.
Only that the exhibition is international because it's not text related. And then this exhibition stayed there for a couple of months. In the meanwhile, I've been doing the, let's say, the skeleton for this book. And it took me 6 years to move from some issues in a magazine to the book itself. And in the meanwhile, I have come to the decision to have one exhibition that will be international and that will be traveling. So the exhibition that you see here has started traveling in 2017 from Sofia, and it has even moved abroad once and will move abroad again this year later.
Good. You are also presenting your first book called In the Path of the Pulsing Light. Okay, when did it come out?
The book was published in 2013 in Bulgarian. And actually, this same year now, in 2020, I'm very happy to announce that we are going to see the English version of it, and it's going to have the title of Following the Pulsing Light. I believe in the forthcoming couple of months, it's going to be a reality, a printed reality, because now it's a reality as a soft copy only. And yeah, my first book is already kind of old, so its first child, the English child, has to be born now. There will be a Russian one, I believe, and a French one later on.
Okay, good. Okay, do you plan another one?
A book or a travel? Or
yeah.
Both, actually, yeah. Yes, of course. I plan a book about my Irish travels. Mm. But in the meanwhile, I would like to organize a big Irish travel around the whole island of Ireland. So I believe when this future trip is done with the bicycle and visiting all the lighthouses, I will have to combine the memories from 2008 to the memories of, let's hope, 2020 or 2021. And it's going to be a big volume like this.
Okay. And what about the new exhibition?
New exhibition, well, yeah. As this one is renewable, actually it's brand new, almost brand new every time, but some new projects are on the way in collaboration with some diplomatic services from different countries. It's not done yet because in all those fields it's kind of slow, but once I have the confirmation, it will be hugely announced everywhere.
Yeah.
And in the meanwhile, I'm planning to present again all the photos from the first exhibition, because it has only been seen in Varna, and now I believe the capital deserves also to see the photos from the very first bicycle trip.
Good, good. Okay, which place would you like to visit this year and why?
I would very much like to do Ireland, but if I'm not able to organize it properly, then I will have to postpone it again. It's been more than 10 years that I postpone it. And I will go to Denmark and maybe some small parts of Sweden and Finland. We'll see, depends on the time and also on the money, of course. But Denmark, almost for sure.
Okay. Thank you, Bela.
Thank you
for the conversation.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
E-volution is supported by Erasmus Plus program of the European Union.